girmeye con lui tipo.
Nice. So, special teach while you drive course from Yousef, compressing his father's 75 years of knowledge into a half an hour car trip.
Yeah, we're going to Abu Sir right now. And the complex, as you know, is called the Bir Netr Hat. Means the house of the place of the Netr. The Netr here was translated into God, like Egyptology. And we know that it is the source for the word nature.
Yeah.
And nature and God are two both flexible words. So Netr is the type of energy that we all know. The complex is very, very much similar to the pyramids area here.
Yeah.
And some of the devices, which is made from the calcite crystals, are still there, the hotebra, the basins. And there are different types of basins, not just the calcite crystals.
The calcite, the alabaster.
Yeah,
it's
crystal. Different than the normal type of alabaster that you see in the... It's white calcite. It's a rare type of calcite crystal. And it's known for transmitting forms of energy and frequency waves and even signals. That's why my father called it the landing zone, because it probably had to do with the teleportation.
Yousef, there were some theories about that the pyramids, somewhere in them, possibly in the capstone, then there's some sort of crystal acting as an antenna or receiver transmitter out into space. Is this the same type of crystal or different type of crystal?
Let's not forget that granite stone is 60% quartz.
Those quartz are white quartz.
And the design that's above the King Chamber is like the largest channeling crystal ever,
right.
That shape. And it's not like Egyptologists think that this design was made to hold the pressure from the weight of the blocks.
No.
Because when you go up there, and there is a very clear example of this in the third pyramid, that when you go above what they think is the burial chamber, you find that the granite is not attached to the limestone.
No,
it's separated. And it's separated to have the loose enough to be vibrating. Attach it to the construction, it can bring it down. This vibration can bring it down. So it has its, like...
It's resonant.
To resonate, it needs this space. Because nothing will hold the pulse inside.
You know what? The other
hydrogen pulses, it can be stronger than nuclear pulses.
This is what I was remembering. In the Pyramid Code DVD, where they show some of the internal chambers, and the ceiling is all black, as if there was some sort of... explosion, discharge, electricity, something.
I will show you.
In the King's chamber.
No doubt. When you see something and you have no doubt about it, you see different types of limestone, which is not from one quarry. You see white calcite, granite stone, rose and black. Not just rose. Find basalt stone, diorite stone, which is the dark green one.
Is diorite a type of granite or a type of basalt?
It's different than both, but it's still, basalt and granite are volcanic stones, so as diorite, but it's more solid.
It's harder.
Pyramid is a Greek word, and it's the real meaning of it is pyramidos, the fire in the middle.
The fire in the middle.
This is the true meaning of it. And it shows, because Christopher Dunn, when he made his research, you know Christopher Dunn, the engineer?
Yeah.
Lost Technologies in ancient Egypt.
Yeah, I've got that.
This
book
one.
With me.
These are the chemetology family guys.
Yeah.
So when he talked, he said the stones were affected with something like fire, but it's not fire. And we know that microwaves, they can have the effect of fire, but it's not fire.
Yeah.
We will see that the stones were like affected by microwaves, that it powderized the stone in a way no water erosion or normal fire or anything at all I have seen that could affect and it's not one stone, it's all the stones from inside the chamber.
Can I ask you, Yousef, in terms of the relationship of water to these sites, and in England, I come from England and I live very close to the ley line alignment in the southeast of England, which obviously there are every year the manifestation of hundreds of crop circles. And I mean, from what I know, the most of these are manifested above sites of water. And the rock, the green limestone, I think it is, that is present beneath it. There are many deep caverns and underwater chambers. And it seems to me as if it's a very similar phenomenon that's happening there.
Can we get out or wait? Can we get out now?
Watch your eyes, these are very sharp, huh? Careful.
Hello, sir. Pieter-Jan.
Hazem.
Hi. Marcus.
Sorry, I didn't see your message earlier because I wasn't there. I don't carry my phone with me.
No worries.
Most of the time.
Okay. Calm down.
But we will go to the white calcite basins first, and then we can go see the other one after we see this one. Or if you like, just to see this one and stay and enjoy the energy there. But the other place where the temple has all the stones affected from the inside is like 25 minutes walking through the desert, which is fun.
Yeah. this is almost what I came for. I wanted a desert. Yeah. I wanted a desert experience.
See how the energy here feels?
Man, it feels so different to the Giza Plateau.
Yeah, the energy there is so corrupted. Man, here it's still pure.
This is unbelievable.
I feel this
all
the time I come here. Like if it's so my first time. The best thing here that we can stay until it gets dark. We can see the stars, we can, you know? That's why I love this place. I remember once I had a dream that this place was already open for visitors and things like that. And I love this figure of the Hot Bra over there, which we're going to be seeing. You see this monument over there?
Mm-hmm.
We'll return back to that. This is where the basins are. So I had this nightmare, I call, that I go there and I lay down.
Nightmare.
You know, I love to lay down in the Hot Bra and energize myself. So I had a nightmare one day that I was going there, and then I find this silly rope that they put around every monument. And I said, I was fighting it, and I woke up with that. Oh, it's a bad dream. You know, doesn't need anyone to activate it.
Uh-huh.
It activates with the cycles. Doesn't need a priest to activate something in it.
Yeah.
It's active with the cycles, with the currents of water, with the rising sun, with the wind blowing, with the earth, of course. So the all elements are already there, and it's designed to function infinitely with all the cycles. But it's not just made for that, as we said, it's made for communication, one way or another. Just the frequency, or maybe teleportation. One of the amazing shapes of the stones, putting each one is in a different figure. You know what does that mean?
The pictures you showed in the presentations come from here.
No, it's from another side, but they're all the same. This is, for example, one of the things you can realize.
I saw them on the granite for the Sphinx Temple as well.
Yeah. And look here. Oh, there are more figures. Amazing. Every time you can see more figures. Look, check out this one. Here is one angle, and here is another. Here is another, and here is another, and here is another. This one is made on purpose. It's not just like, go straight from here and then from here, and there is another angle here, and there is another angle. You see, you can find like nine facets, nine angles in one stone. You know what this means? It means that they had to do one stone at a time.
Yeah, that's one big puzzle.
So they would be still working until today, if they, you know? They wouldn't finish the construction until today, if you're trying to build every piece. And they, of course, they manufacture it here. So they bring it as a slab from the quarry they brought it from. And here they start to design this one like this, and this one like that, and this one like this. Why? It was to work with the pulse of the pyramidus. Remember this phrase very well. From a pyramid, pyramidus. The fire in the middle had, like the running water would generate this electricity pulse every few seconds, right? The two currents of water. There are many currents of water were running. So the pulse happened from electricity and other energies every like few seconds. Boom, 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 like that. That's how it was working, functioning. Try to imagine it. And we'll see the effect of the stone into the other temple front of this pyramid over there. But let's see some of the things here too. The awareness of the 360 senses. My father used to talk about them all the time. We are crippled now, thinking that we only, they could bring stones all the way from Rwanda until here. There was no limit, nobody, no figures. There was no Libya. Mm. There was no, all these nations start to appear like in the Middle Kingdom, but we're talking pre-dynastic. There was, it was Sish, all, because all the 42 tribes were originally from here. So nobody thought of like, this is my place and this is yours. This is all ours. And we're talking about granite stone. Granite stone. If you get all the metal in the world and bam, bam, it will get flat and it's not gonna crack it.
Yeah.
But you see? Each one of these is one single piece of limestone. It's in a perfect shape, huh? Listen to this. It's hollow. It is hollow.
It's granite.
That's black granite. Volcanic, solid. Only here.
There.
Only around that edge. Huh. Not here. Not here. No way.
These are. Yeah, you can hear the difference.
Clearly.
You can see them. You can see the machining marks here.
Is it machining or frequency?
Because
the machining wouldn't leave this waxy material on it. There is a creamy material like on top of it, like volcanic glass that build up.
Yeah, yeah.
This was from the frequency.
Ah, and then it sort of, the lines are just the...
The small blocks would be like 4 tons and 5 tons, and some of them can be 30 tons, and some of them can be 100 tons, and some of them can be 300 tons. There is one statue in Upper Egypt made from granite, one solid piece. Everyone say this used to be 1,000-ton piece of granite. Show me someone who can move 1,000 ton now. Today, not like thousands of years ago. It could be a very simple technique, but we are not just there.
Yeah.
We are thinking about all explosion energies and things like that.
We're approaching it from the wrong angle.
Exactly.
Asking the wrong questions.
But it can be a very simple device. If you are tuned in with nature, you would see it. If you are able to see the flood every year and see what happens with it, you will find that with more things than studying in college for ages. The same technique here of building the stones like puzzle, you can see. And the place is over there. Look at this. Look at that. Each one is different than the other. It was just easier to make them cubes.
Yeah. Tell me again why they're shaped individually. Tell me again why they are shaped individually.
They are shaped individually because each one looked different. That's why they had to be, each one must have been made on its own, like individually.
Yeah, yeah.
But they are put in like this to resist or to work with vibration. Because if they were squares, they will dismantle easily. Welcome, my brother. Do you see the basalt stone from the other side? Look at it from here. Does it look like it has been affected at all from here? It's quite solid. Touch it. This is basalt stone, volcanic. It's not something easy to be scratched. And come look how is it affected from this side.
Gosh.
Powderized. Can you tell me what would possibly make the stone go like that? And only from the inside of the chamber. أنا هجنن لكم العالم العربي والأجنبي بس استنوا
يا همو سير
ولا كتابة ولا بتاع الشرح على المصمت على طول Do you see?
Can use another footage for my video here.
What about Robert Shaw?
Yeah. What about him?
You don't think he'd be the man?
To see what?
To see this?
Any geologist, he's welcome. I am positive. I have seen. I work with the stones, remember. And I have seen stones has been affected by fire, and I know how it looks like, the normal fire.
Yeah.
And I have seen stones that was affected by water.
Mm-hmm.
And this doesn't look. This is a volcanic stone. It was made from fire. Christopher Dunn didn't see this piece yet. But I'm sure I'm sure
the striations.
Yes. And look here. Looks like a disc. Spinning, very thin. Look at it. There is no marks of chisel can do this, I guarantee you that. And look at the edge over here. Something was. It's not just spinning, because even with spinning, you wouldn't have all the lines are matching together like that. Something else.
Just keep it there.
Okay? It was affected by the frequency, that's why it isolated.
Hmm.
It's coming from inside there to outside here. Pouring in the basin from here. The water is still here. Come look at it from this. Design or from this angle, because the wall you're standing on is not a straight wall. It was probably part of another pyramid. Look at this one. The angle of this wall here shows that it could possibly be part of another pyramid. And this was coming out of it, pouring water from the temple. And of course, this is not something that's really obvious. So these basins were originally some devices works with the frequency and with water and completing the dynamic of the complex. This is the crystal colocyte.
Yeah, I saw one. You picked one yesterday at the pyramids as well.
Yeah, they're all over, transmitting stones, especially the quartz and the crystals could work with signals.
Yeah.
Not just like energy currents like electricity, but it can work like as a transmitting device, like a radio.
Yeah, it stores information.
Yeah, exactly.
And releases
radio waves. Radio.
Marcus, my head, and I can't remember. He was a German guy who was persecuted in America for his.
Yes. Can't remember the name either.
I'm going to make some more going when I get home, and this is going to go straight.
So this is alabaster. This is
crystal calcite. Calcite crystal. And I don't believe in the theory that we were extraterrestrial and then came back here. No. We were generated from this earth and we're going back to it.
Mm.
This is our physical body and our soul belongs to God.
Mm-hmm.
Here is the part of the world that used to surround this pyramid, as you can see. And it's to keep the water in. The construction was in the water. The pyramid itself could be in water, yeah, running water. Sort of the second pyramid.
Moat around the water.
Yeah. This kind of culture had no problem in transferring these weights to any place. Like, distance was not a problem. Any distance you can imagine. Anywhere in the world. Like, any weight you can imagine, till 1,000 ton or more. From any place in the world. Any figure that they want to shape. Like, unlimited power. That's why I said, like, to have this power, why do you need to build something to get your power? If you already have the power to do that. So this must have been for something else. Here is another.
And how long do you think that's been lying like that?
What?
This granite, it's just sitting there with two.
After, there is the marks of quarry in it. These ones. This is how the people used to come and cut the stones from the sides. And it's a shame that Egyptologists saying that this is the same the ancient Egyptians cut their stones, because it's so obvious.
Yeah, it's such a difference, this and this.
Yeah, how can you come out with this outstanding finish here? And...
Hello again.
So it's not a coincidence in one of the drills, it's in all of them. You're gonna find some like this in Karnak as well.
It's amazingly smooth in size, incredible.
As you can see, look at him, he's saying about this, the smooth part in the inside here.
It's just
if you looked with enough light, you will see a very thin layer of, as I tell you, something looks similar to volcanic glass.
Like silica, silica glass?
Like silica stone or volcanic glass.
That was a bit silica reminded there.
So I have a piece in my house. I put it in my altar. It's like this big. If I went with you to the museum, I will show you that they have a chunk like this big. They have a showcase showing the materials. You know what is the weight of the obelisk? One of the obelisk weighs 600 tons. One solid piece of granite. And they say Hatshepsut put it in the place for decoration. So come up with a better explanation. Okay, they came up with another explanation. It was for like to know what time is it by the sun. Come on, you can grow a tree and it will give you the same. You can put a piece of wood and it will give you the same results. You don't have to cut a 600 ton block just to make a sun clock, you know? And they wouldn't have to make 12 sundials in the same place. Like to cut 12 obelisks in the same place.
Yeah. You can basically see the surface looks of it as if it's polished, basically.
It has a layer of transparent material.
Must be superheated, though.
It's like heat, but it's not. It's the frequency. You see, you said the same thing. It's like superheated. The same thing you find inside the Great Pyramid. But it's all these mosquitoes. Christopher Dunn was talking about what they know as the Queen's Chamber was actually the room that handled the separating the oxygen from the hydrogen from the water. One, there are no writings, there is nothing. So when you see the stela, and you see the, they call it the stela of dream for Tutmosis, and they think he put it there, no, the stela was already there with the design on it. All what he did is adding his dream and the writing and putting the two sphinxes and the inscriptions, and you will see that the manufacturing or like carving of them is totally different than the shape of the sacred geometry and the stone. And all the maps are leading, as we can see, that this one is leading to another room, and here too. But it's hollow from the other side, different than here. And it was closed with these two edges here, to see it like it was as one part of the wall.
Right.
Because all the shafts lead to each other. There was a well here. And lots of water. That's why we see a big deposit of salt. And the people call this room the crystal room. That's actually, it's that salt. It took long time here, really long time, until it built up. You see?
Oh yeah. So is that like what it was in the Queen's Chamber as well, and the hallway of the Queen's Chamber?
You can find it also in, but in a different one, like even thicker than that, in the Red Pyramid, in the higher chamber, mm-hmm. on the edges of the wall, there is a big deposit like that thick,
mm-hmm. okay.
which takes, geologists used to say it takes a million years to build up, but I think not. Maybe the circumstances for what was happening, which also affected the stone to make it look red. Because if you look at parts of the stone that's broken, it's white from the inside. So the pulse that was inside is what changed the color of the stone like that. Yeah, that's why they call it the Red Pyramid.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Temples above temples.
Yeah.
There's a whole level of construction that's still buried underground. It's much more amazing than that. Okay. Because Minkaura originally means the triple images of the fertility of the sun. And Kha'ifra, it's a stage that's manifested by the sun. So it all talks about like stages of the sun and energies and the earth
okay.
Energies as well, because the design of the pyramid, of course, will absorb earth's energy.
Sure.
And it's tuned in with water and air and fire.
Right.
So the whole four elements and the sound frequency is the fifth element.
Right.
So Amun Ra.
This is the reed of the bamboo that grows by the canal, and it bends like this only when the wind blows, so it represents air. Also, it's the crown of the netter shoe, which he represented air. Then we have men, which is earth,
like this one, men, right here.
And N is the water, and Ra is the fire or the sun. So when you see Amun Ra, you have air, earth, water, and fire.
It's not a god, it's the four elements.
Right.
Very, very. The pressure will be so high that if they had another pipe from another area, this pressure will push the water out.
Right.
All the way to the pyramids.
So it's in a perfect balance. It's just,
yeah. Some people thought like this was a technique to elevate the stones,
uh-huh.
but it was just for the water system to keep going up and then going down.
Which generated the power. I mean,
it had to be running water. Yeah. It had to be the running water with the beam of the sun and the sand. This is the combination. This was one of the ones that was transformed into a tomb later, and that's why they opened it up like this for the box. And this way to slide the box down is the same technique they used in the Valley of the Kings. Because the Valley of the Kings had a map of tunnels just like these, and that was also transformed into tombs.
So you don't think the Valley of the Kings was originally...
No.
Okay. You think it was part of the same system?
Of course. All of the sites. Down here is the same design that we saw in the room underneath the ground and in the stela. Look at this one. This is the most ancient symbol in the culture. Really. And until today I'm researching it, I don't know.
Sorry.
It's okay. I don't know what it is.
You don't know what it is?
I don't know what it is. These are, of course, I know. These are the normal hieroglyphs. And it was added to the design later. This is the same original design for the sacred geometry. Like the one in the stela front of the Sphinx. It continues down here with the regulator as well. We think it's the front of a castle. What is it anyway?
Shaft is going to the left. There is a room here. And as you can see, we're in the bottom of the shaft or the well. And then we have a room, and then we have another. The other room to the other side. Do you have a flashlight or something?
Oh, no, actually.
And that goes down.
Mm-hmm. So one of the shafts can be taken two layers, because the way here can be also in another shaft that's shorter. So there are long wells and short wells, and so one can pour to the other, and then they will lead here, and then this one, of course, will lead to other tunnels.
Sure.
Yeah, and then it will be elevated up again. Where you can see the entrance of it all surrounding the middle pyramid. Why?
Around the middle pyramid?
Around the middle pyramid.
Oh,
there
really?
Are doors that's closed to those blocks of stone. They are leading to the rest of this shaft.
The idea is that the second pyramid is older than the Great Pyramid.
Yeah, the second pyramid is probably the most ancient one at the site. That's because the location,
yeah,
and because also the more ancient you go, the more massive stones you see. It's not like when you get advanced, you use bigger. No, the more ancient you go, the more the slabs of stone are like amazing.
Yeah.
When you look at around the middle pyramid, the stones are like 300 tons the block.
Really?
Yeah, and they are put together that when you are working on them, you would think that it's one piece. Unless you see the line of the square that you are working around. The slabs are, some of them was also made in the puzzle way that I showed in the lecture. Huge design, not like small ones that like we saw in Abu Sir. Bigger design. We can look at it on the way to the other. So this is about the shafts. We will go see the other room, feel the sound, resonance,
okay,
technique.
Great.
Okay.
Right, just to take a first look at this,
it
scares me.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a false story. This is the sound regulator. And this is the same design in the temple to help amplify the frequency of the sound. You can set them, I'll talk to you.
Have a seat.
So that's where we know that this is original and the statue came later.
Ah.
Yeah, with the least sound you make.
Okay,
this is called gis. It's the material that they used to put in these places. It's not even carved. It used to be like cement or like gips. And they put it here in order to put the right things and everything.
Are you familiar with cement?
Know how energy works.
And it changes all your matter.
Sacred geometry. Consider your body is made up of mostly water. This is the healing energy that's happening with tone.
There is another one also on the other side, but
with no restrictions.
If you sit here and tone yourself, you become the tone. Yeah. You have the feeling more that
tone. Yeah, you can really feel that.
The thing is, there is a shift right behind this. We will see it when we get out.
Okay.
There's a shift right behind it.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Well, that's where it gets the itself.
I think the resonance.
From the running water underneath the ground.
Right.